first thing we got to do is right here on your safety screw, which is a retaining screw for your cocking indicator, make sure the part of it that is cut out is facing the cocking indicator, and on this gun it is, so the cocking indicator should just tap right out. Cocking indicator is under some pressure though. This whole linkage assembly is from the block. So let's tap the split pin out for the block. Get the breech block out. Bag your parts as you remove them. You don't want to have to buy new ones. IMA's got plenty according to their parts list, but why buy them if you don't need to? How much screwdriver fell apart? Let's double check, make sure the slot is where it's supposed to be. It is. The cutout is towards the when you remove your breech block, I'll go ahead and put it in. You push down on the nose and you cock it and it'll pop right out as it just did. I try to put it back in, but right now this whole receiver is so hot. I'm sitting out in the sun, I can barely stand to touch it. All right, there's no more spring pressure on the cocking indicator. And it's still not moving. Not sure why. Let's tap some more. It's moving now. All right, I'm going to use the large end of my punch on the head of it. Tap it out. Throw it in the bag. I'm going to take the sling swivel screw off the trigger guard right now. It's coming right apart. Everything has been sitting in soaking up brake fluid, and that's been eating a lot of this grime, so it could be why everything's coming apart so easily. Usually you don't have a problem getting these screws out. Using the edge of my screwdriver to clean the filth out of this screw slot. All right, and that's a reassembly is exactly opposite. You got to put your cocking lever in your trigger guard before you put it in. Now let's take the trigger guard assembly apart, the trigger assembly, if we can. Got one screw for the spring. Spray everything up with penetrating fluid. You take it and the breech block, cover it all with brake fluid. Let that sit on there and eat the grease. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and swab the barrel out. Clean the barrel. Stop right here. I will show you when you clean your barrel, take your steel wool, wrap it around your shotgun cleaning attachment as I have. I don't know what it is, cleaning jag, cleaning, it's for patches, but I shove the coarse steel wool through the slotted end and wrap it. I'm going to scrub the barrel out while everything's soaking in the brake fluid, and then we'll pick up disassembling the breech block. Alright, here's the receiver. I'm going to try to show you the receiver on both sides. As you can see, there's a lot of the original bluing left. It is a, like I said, it was an unmarked, untouched Mark II. It does have a very, very faint 1876, I believe, on it. I'm gonna strip the block assembly now. Let you see that. For the block assembly, when I strip it, I'm gonna go ahead and use some kind of heavy steel wool to wipe some of the heavy grease on it. Right now the stuff has been really softened by the brake fluid, and it's just more or less wiping off with the steel wool rather than me actually having to scrub it. Okay, let's take it apart. On the back side, there is another safety screw, or rather it's a retaining screw, it's a locking screw with another half moon cutout on it to prevent the internals from the breech block from working out. Turn it so that the slot is towards the breech block. Stick your screwdriver in here, just spin it up. Now wipe everything down. The internals haven't been soaked in the brake fluid, more or less they just need wiped off. That grease really comes off them easy after they've been soaked in brake fluid. The spring's in good shape. I'm going to wipe the spring off. Trying to position everything on the table so that you can see it.